and welcome to another episode of Intelligent CX Cube, where we deep dive into the latest innovations and enhancement in SAP CX and industry solutions. My name is Kati. I'm a customer insights consultant as part of the Industries and CX Product Engineering Organization at SAP. Today, we have an exciting topic to discuss, the integration of SAP Customer Data Platform and Emarsys. Joining us today are Alex and Nick, who will not only walk us through the native integrations between SAP CDP and Emarsys, but also explaining the advantages of this powerful interplay. Hey, great to have you both with us today. To begin, could you please describe why SAP has put a lot of efforts into the integration of Customer Data Platform and Emarsys?
SAP recognizes the growing importance of personalization and omnichannel engagement in today's customer-centric landscape. By connecting operational data with contextual data, we enable businesses to personalize their interaction and engage customers on their preferred channels.
The integration of SAP Customer Data Platform and Emarsys allows organizations to collect and activate rich permission-based data, unifying customer data into a single model and leverage AI-powered insights to deliver meaningful interactions at scale. This investment empowers businesses to drive profitable growth and build long-lasting customer relationships.
That sounds promising. Now, can you also provide us with some concrete scenarios in which customers can leverage this integration?
Sure. With the integration of SAP Customer Data Platform and Emarsys, businesses can orchestrate customer journeys that span both online and offline touchpoints. This means they can power revenue-generating marketing campaigns, engage in lifecycle engagements to drive loyalty, and optimize customer lifetime value. By leveraging a real-time cross-channel automation engine, organizations can meet their customers where they want to be met, delivering personalized experiences based on consent-based preferences and behavior signals.
Whether it's traditional email or SMS, whether it's mobile app, social media, or any other channel, with this first-class integration, we enable businesses to engage with their consumers in the most efficient way.
All right, that's really fascinating. Could you explain how customers can benefit most from that along with their existing SAP S/4HANA system landscape? How does this primarily focus on B2C companies or also target B2B companies who are following our business partners' relationship data model?
All customers can benefit from this integration in multiple ways. By unifying fragmented customer data from relevant sources and bridging functional silos through a centralized data model, businesses, whether B2C or B2B, can gain a comprehensive understanding of their customers.
And again, this enables them to deliver trusted, personalized interaction at every step of the customer's journey. So now, let's have a closer look in the system and get inspired about the integrations in action.
At the beginning, we have to set up the connection. We do so in sources or destination. We click on Connect application, search for Emarsys, and pick up our connector. We name the connection as we please for easier navigation in CDP later, and we insert our prepared API user and API secret. Please don't forget to set up this API user with the right permission, which is documented on the help portal. We click on Connect. Within a moment, the connector appears with all its components. Now let's enable the magic. First, we set up purposes, which is prerequisite to activate the connector. I have prepared purpose called Marketing CX Demo Blue. In the next step, we can adjust the default schema by adding or removing further fields to be synced with Emarsys. That's it. The application is available and we can activate the data sync. After creating, connecting and enabling, let's see closer the schema adjustment by creating a custom field in CDP. this change is immediately available in Emarsys. Let's double check it under Management, Field Editor, and search for the right name. Voila, the test field is here. As you probably know, all the fields which are managed by our connector are created with the prefix CD underscore. Similarly to existing connector with Customer Data Cloud. In Emarsys, I search for a profile and want to change the name from Dominik Hajda to Alex Lepap. I'll perform the name change in Customer Data Cloud, which is also part of our near real-time synchronization. The change instantly cascades from Customer Data Cloud to Customer Data Platform and finally reaches Emarsys. Dominik Hajda is being changed to Alex Lepap. How is the data reflected? Let's refresh the screen, or maybe twice. Our magic happens in just a couple of seconds. The name has changed to the desired value. Final look to Emarsys screen. Alex is here. Yay! Near real time.
We've seen the Emarsys activities in CDP, but we are also going to see other types of activities. And in this environment, which is connected to Emarsys as well, I can see the different activities performed by that selection of people. For instance, I have orders and also have tickets on some of them, because obviously not everyone has a ticket. Let me find a good example, someone with a ticket. Here you go. So you can see we get other types of activities, like we would see the email campaign activities for Emarsys, but we can also get ticket information from the CRM, for instance, or we could get orders information from the commerce channels. And for each of these users, there's going to be a few more details that we will be sharing. First of all, they have their own data purposes that we got from their consent. And we can see some segmentation was performed on them as well, right? As well as some counters that are available around the number of tickets, for instance, or the number of orders, or the sum of all the spending that would be available there and shared. The new feature, which is called Direct Data Access, allows you to expose all of this through a HANA connection that we'll be leveraging from Emarsys, and we will set it up in that view here. The first step is to leverage the different purposes that are available in the CDP configuration so that only the people who actually accepted and provided a consent about that type of sharing are actually going to be shared. It goes even down to the limiting potential number of attributes that are going to be shared that way. But in that case, I'm showing and sharing pretty much everything. So if I go in that CDP view configuration, I can review the matching between how the data is organized in the main database of CDP on the left and how it works and how it's represented in flattened view for direct data access, and therefore how the HANA connectivity will represent it to Emarsys. We can see that pretty much everything is shared here, all these attributes in the profile, including the segments and indicators that we just discussed, as well as the activities. In that case, I have my orders here, where all the attributes and the tickets in a similar way. This is shared through a connection with HANA Cloud, and you will have all the information here to actually connect from Emarsys relational data configuration into that view. So in practice, you would just copy paste all these credentials and configuration into Emarsys. Speaking of which, let's move there. And you can see I could just select create a new connection, choose HANA Cloud as the type, and then I would just need to paste the credentials we just saw, and you would get a valid connection in Emarsys to the CDP data. I have one which is already set up there. You can see all the attributes that we're just discussing before that I simply pasted from the purpose view configuration screen in CDP. Now from there, I could do two things. I can do segmentation, or I could do personalization in Emarsys. Let's start with segmentation. You can see that I've created already a few templates. Let me show you a few that I prepared. This first is based on CDP profiles, where CDP's own segment information is made available. For instance, you can see the generation segment that we had. So whether people are Gen Xs, millennials, etc., which is available in one of the views that we expose from CDP. As shown before, we have the view for the profile, the view for the tickets, and the view for the orders.
the three views we saw in CDP configuration, and you can see them here. Getting back to profiles, if I want the millennials or the Gen Zs, I can just run and I'll get that information directly in real time from CDP in there. And I can use that to build a template. So when I want to build a segment in Emarsys and to run a campaign over it, I'll be able to select exactly that. Looking at a different example here, for instance, I can take that one, which is a bit more complicated and actually leverages the tickets view this time that we exposed and allows me to choose several criteria, such as the ticket category, the status, the sentiment, etc. And if I run that again, I'll get an update and I can see that information straight into Emarsys as a segment template. Just to double check that the data is actually aligned, if I move from here to my CDP back again and search for that specific user, I can indeed see that that user is Skylark. If I go in the activities, I can see that the criteria that we selected in Emarsys, so people with tickets about support that are closed and with a neutral sentiment, and I can see that that specific ticket is indeed here, in that user, close with a neutral sentiment, and it was around support. So that's a match for that specific segment. So that is the segmentation preparation part. And then to use it, I can simply go to context, segments, and there I can leverage all these templates to prepare my campaigns. So the people spent, for instance, was the one of these templates, and I can choose to have a segment for people who spend more than 250, for instance. And if I save that, that's going to be my new segment, which can then be combined with other segments for adding or removing specific contacts, for instance, for people who already received email recently from Emarsys. So that's a pretty standard way to utilize segments in Emarsys and a very standard way to operate the CDP data, just like any other kind of relational data set in Emarsys. Now that we've covered the segments, we can talk about the personalization aspect. And this is, again, set up in a very classic way for any relational data connection in Emarsys. I just go into my table and views. Please ignore the two in the middle. They're from a previous exercise. But you can see here on the view for tickets and the view for orders and the main view for profiles. But the most important ones are going to be the ones about the tickets and the orders. I already configured them, obviously, but the way you would do it is that you select your reference field, so the main key that is used in both CDP and Emarsys, and is aligned with the previous steps that were described in this video around the synchronization of the profiles from CDP into Emarsys contacts. Then you can choose the attributes that you want to leverage for the sorting, so that when setting up the actual personalization token, you can select the right item, for instance, the last order or the last ticket. You can see the configuration details here. If I just add everything here and just reload this with additional data, you can see all the orders. And now, if I go into my tickets and go into the preview here, I'll be able, again, to see the entire data set coming from CDP. Then, based on these settings, I'll be able to create personalization tokens very, very easily. Let me just show you how to do that in the content personalization. As you can see, I have a few tokens that are already there that we already configured before as an example. And for instance, that one, which is about the subject of the last ticket. You can see I've just selected the ticket table, and then you also need to specify how to do the alignment of identifiers, and you're good to go. You can use that. You can use that token in your templates. And that's pretty much it. Thank you for your attention.
Welcome to the world of SAP Intelligent CX. Our comprehensive suite of applications seamlessly integrates front-end and back-end systems, providing a unified and streamlined approach to managing customer interactions. We incorporate artificial intelligence that allows your team to work smarter and faster, and our industry-tailored use cases and partner ecosystem empowers organizations to deliver extraordinary experiences, build lasting relationships, and drive sustainable growth. Our composable SAP Customer Experience Suite enables leading brands to understand and protect customer data, increase lifetime value with personalized journeys, close more business faster, drive consistently profitable commerce outcomes, and deliver automated and agent-assisted service. Learn how you can deliver extraordinary customer experiences. Visit sap.com/cx.